It was the biggest one I'd ever seen. Nearly 59 pounds, quite a handful. But more than just the size, it was firm, moist, and had an all-over glow. I knew then that this was what I wanted to do with my life.
Start of the growing season for Sherry Brown, three times winner of the Scottish Branch Championships with her green bush marrows.
Here's a picture of me with my 2001 winner. It came in at 23 inches long and 8 inches thick. I called him Baby because he was so big. That really was some marrow, wasn't it?
Si, he was a really big one.
Some marrow. Margarita's been my cleaner for over a year now, si. And she really knows the work I put in, especially when it gets round to competition time. I have actually seen her, I swear, talking to the marrows when she thinks there's no one else around. It's so easy to become attached.
Over at Longview, Gaynor Plum is preparing the temperature for her seedlings. This is Gaynor's first time growing marrows, but she's confident she can bring a fresh approach to the competition.
Well, it's amazing. It has opened up a whole new social scene for me. Really, I thought when I moved here last year, I would have a really difficult time fitting in. But since joining the National Vegetable Society, people have welcomed me with open arms. It's amazing. One of the first things you notice about competitive vegetable growing is how close it can bring a small town like this. There is a whole lot of love here. Last year, my neighbor, Mr. Evans, grew 19-pound carrots, won all sorts of awards. He got over 30 cards and gifts. You don't get that sense of community from everywhere you move. Now, I've decided this year I'm going to start with the marrows because I've heard they're one of the easiest of the trailing vegetables to grow.
How do you feel about being up against the three times champion, Sherry Brown?
Sherry? Well, yes, of course I'd love to win, but it is taking part that's the most important thing to me.
I've had so many people say to me, Sherry, it must be like carrying a child, months of waiting and preparing and watching something grow, for someone like me who doesn't have children.
As the seasons change, marrows have to be removed from their indoor environment and planted in garden plots.
More women nowadays are taking to horticulture, and the men in the society are extremely encouraging. You can tell a lot about a man by the way he handles his vegetables.
Thank you, Margarita. I'm enjoying myself so much, I find I have very little time on my hands. I've had to hire a cleaner to come in once a day to help me with things around the house. Growing marrows is a full-time job. Fluffy! Fluffy! Shoo! Cat Fluffy! Mr. Evans, your cat is in my garden again! Now, I've started adding a feed of liquid manure and dried blood about twice a month. I find it keeps the vegetables moist yet firm. Now John, he's the butcher, has been super supportive. He even stops by on his way home from work when his wife's at the bingo.
As the competition draws near, vegetable mania seems to hit this Borders town. For Sherry, this year's competition is not without its problems.
It was 22 and a half inches by this time last year. I just can't believe it's only 22 and a quarter. The soil was moister. Oh, fetch me the basin.
Hello.
How do you feel that this year's new entrant, Gainer Plum, has a marrow of 22 3/4 inches at this stage?